Let's now get an update on the traffic situation along the North Luzon Expressway, where authorities waive toll fees at the plaza heading to the Philippine Arena. Our correspondent Jeffrey Arnaez joins us live from the Balintawak Toll Plaza for more. Jeffrey?
Hi, Ron. This is not what everyone was expecting to happen today, especially at an event as big as the FIBA World Cup, where traffic flow is surprisingly smooth here on the North Luzon Expressway. Early on, many already headed to the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange with their tickets for the FIBA World Cup opening. Instead of bringing cars, they took advantage of the free rides to the venue at the Philippine Arena in Bulacan, avoiding heavy traffic to and from Bulacan to Metro Manila after the games. Some chose to stay overnight at the Philippine Arena, leading to a full parking area and minimal traffic on NLEX. At around 3:30 p.m., the NLEX Traffic Control Center only reported a 100-meter vehicle queue at Balintawak Toll Plaza and around 50 meters at Mindanao and Bukawi Toll Plazas. NLEX also announced toll fee access for Class 1 vehicles exiting Ciudad de Victoria to the Philippine Arena from 12 noon to 3 p.m. NLEX also assured that their personnel are ready to manage traffic after the FIBA games today.
Malinaw na malinaw po yung mga signages dun sa loob. Meron po lahat yun, to Manila, to Tarlac, makikita po nila yung mga routes doon sa loob ng Philippine Arena. Even yung paglapas pa lang po nila ng parking area, dinesign na po namin yun na hindi sila sabay-sabay sa isang exit.
After the first day of the FIBA World Cup, those who rode the free buses from PITX will be transported back to the PITX Central Station, where many park their cars or will board buses to return home. Meanwhile, Ron, tomorrow there's an expected increase in traffic around the Araneta Coliseum in Quezon City and Mall of Asia Arena again in Pasay City due to highly anticipated games of basketball powerhouses China and Team USA. Ron.
Jeffrey Arnaez with that update. Thanks.
In other news, Gilas Pilipinas will face Dominican Republic as the FIBA World Cup kicks off today. We have Jack Batalones joining us live from the Philippine Arena with the latest. Jack, how's the atmosphere there?
Well, the atmosphere here, Denise, is great, and everyone is excited because today is game day here at the Philippine Arena in Bukawi, Bulacan for the official start of the 2023 FIBA World Cup. Denise, as early as noontime today, the fans have begun to come in wearing their jerseys, bringing their banners and even flags just to show their support for our national team. Some of them even came from as far as Bicol and Sorsogon just to watch the opening games. President Bongbong Marcos is expected to grace the opening ceremonies and will do the ceremonial jump ball in the second game. There is an ongoing game now between Italy and Angola. And for the second game, our very own Gilas Pilipinas will be facing Dominican Republic. Dominican Republic will be powered by NBA All-Star Karl Anthony Towns of the Minnesota Timberwolves. Towns is a 6'11 big man who can shoot from the outside, a former Rookie of the Year, and a three-time All-Star. Over at the Gilas side, Utah Jazz star and former Sixth Man of the Year, Jordan Clarkson, will reinforce our national team. Gilas coach Chot Reyes said they have scouted their opponents and studied how to handle Towns.
We're putting in a lot of effort in perfecting our offense as well. Do we have the goods? Do we have the team? Hard to say. One thing is for sure, we will need the support and the prayers of the crowd.
Okay, Denise, while there are opening games here at the Philippine Arena, there are a couple of games right now at the Mall of Asia Arena as part of the opening day. And there's a game between Mexico and Montenegro and Egypt and Lithuania. Denise.
Thanks, Jack.
The Philippine Trade Department urged to craft measures to curb the proliferation of fake goods in the country, particularly untested medical products being advertised on social media platforms. Senator Aimee Marcos made the call following an avalanche of disclaimers from popular medical practitioners and celebrities disavowing any ties with the fake and unregistered products. In the meantime, Senator Jingo Estrada called on fellow lawmaker Mark Villar, who chairs a trade, commerce, and entrepreneurship panel, to take action given the risks the public faces in using fake products.
Sana nga ay makapagpatawag na ng committee hearing sa lalong madaling panahon dahil talaga namang nakakabahala ang mga naglipa ng fake ads online. At hindi pa malinaw kung paano mapapanagot ang mga nasa likod nito, lalo't saklaw ang social media platforms sa ating mga batas sa ngayon.